Okay, my head is still bobbing from that beat. Oh my God, I love this song. That song. That's a new intro for Drinking Buddies, guys. I hope that you like it. Now, this is our first audience participation piece right here. The first person in comments who tells me the artist of that song that we intro'd to. I'm going to give you guys, I'm going to shoot you out a Business and Bourbon cocktail kit. So you can have a cocktail on me. First person that puts that in comments. Guys, welcome to Drinking Buddies. We are back. Drinking Buddies, it's me, it's you, a buddy, and we're going to talk some business. I'm really excited about today's show. For those of you guys that have not watched Drinking Buddies before, it's really about sharing some business wisdom, man. So you know, I invite my personal friends onto the show. We're going to talk about business. And then they're going to share a little bit more. We're going to peel back the curtain a little bit on what they do and how they can benefit you. Today, I'm really excited because we're going to talk about technology sales and we're going to get into diversity inclusion. Diversity and inclusion. Like, we all hear that all the time. If you work for a big company, you're probably seeing memos and emails and whatever else, Slack groups about this every day. But what the hell is it? What is it? Well, we're going to talk about it. We're going to pull back the curtain a little bit with our guest today. Before we get started, remind you guys that Drinking Buddies is brought to you by Business and Bourbon. If you are not checking out our platforms, you need to right now. Make sure that you get on to businessandbourbon.live. Become a community member. So many fun things that we're about to announce starting actually next week. And I'm so excited. I might even tease some of it today. But before I introduced our guest, got to make sure you guys remember what it is that we're doing right now out there with Business and Bourbon and our virtual experiences. So check out this little piece and we'll be right back. Welcome in to Business and Bourbon. We've got whiskey. I couldn't be any better.
And go ahead and take a sip with me.
Excited to do this, really am.
I'm curious.
First things first, you guys have all received a box. And in that box, there are some beautiful elements that we're going to use this evening. Richie Michaels! What's going on, Richie?
Ronell, how are you, buddy? It's great to see your face. This is an industry standard piece of glassware that we use for tasting whiskey in the industry. And you'll notice that one side, you can smell more than the other side. And so for me right now, my dominant nostril is my left side. Once we found our dominant nostril, that is the side that we are going to use to taste with for the rest of the tasting experience.
I know it's like picking a favorite child, but if you had to pick one, which would it be?
You know, I have a sweet tooth, so I'm always going to go for something sweet. But I always like high proof. I drink whiskey every day, y'all.
The number one thing that I want you to keep in mind is this event is about you. We want you to have fun.
If everyone is ready, go ahead and grab your Glencairn glass and pour in some of your first whiskey that we're trying today, which is the Fiddler from the American Spirit Whiskey Company.
I want to hear from a couple of you out there. What do you think?
Non-whiskey. Oh.
Non-whiskey, non-bourbon.
First of all, before you answer it, there's such a thing? What? They're making bourbon everywhere, and I often curate bourbons from all over the country.
I've never done anything, you know, like this virtually, so it was great.
This is beautiful.
It's good.
Yeah, shout out to our friends at Glass River Media who produced that. All right, I'm excited about this, guys. Without any further ado, I want to bring on Kelli McMillan. Good afternoon, Kelli.
Hello, sir. How are you?
I'm awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, Kelli McMillan is a national partner manager with Five9, and she's the founder of Xposure. I can't wait to dig into that. But all in due time. First and foremost, this is Drinking Buddies. So the first thing our folks need to know, first, I need to know what you guys are drinking. And if you do not have a drink in your hands right now, what are you doing? You know how we do. You know what this is about. So go ahead and pour your drink. Before I tell you what I'm drinking, Kelli, what are you drinking?
So I've been kind of known in the industry in my little circles for always ordering elaborate drinks, and not even by trying, like I don't even try to do it, but it happens. And so what I'm drinking today has Chambord in it. It's champagne with a little bit of Chambord, and it's quite
you know. One of
my favorite things. Like I'll add Chambord to margaritas, to a Riesling, like whatever. So, but my favorite thing is Chambord and Brut champagne. So
you are so fancy.
Yes.
Check you. Oh my God. Check you out. And the backdrop is fire. I've seen that before. And it is fire. Can you come and design mine? I'm going to invite you over to the house just so you can hook mine up. Cause you got it all Zen. You got the Zen going on and you got the champagne. I love it. What books? Okay. We need to know what Kelly's reading. What are the top three books on your cabinet there?
I have to be honest, like I have top three books that are on my cabinet, but I'm a big Audible person these days. You know how we want to go. And I'll have to go to my Audible and let you know what I'm reading. I just finished the marathon, Don't Stop the Life and Times of Nipsey Hussle, which.
Oh,
yes.
Interesting.
Right? Wouldn't think that it's a business book, but it really is. He talks about like the author that is depicting Nipsey's life talks about the art of war and another book with regards like, you know, the concepts around marketing, the 22 laws of marketing, I think it's called.
What's up, Ian?
Amazing. and so that's a good book. I just finished that one. I'm reading right now. It's About Damn Time by Arianne Hamilton. She was the first African-American woman VC founder. And so she has she's a venture capitalist and she just kind of taught herself how to do it. So that's another good book. And then, what else is on this list? Like I have so many.
Okay. Well, we only need three. I don't need, you know, I'm gonna have a hard time with one. You know how I do.
Oh, you know what? One thing that's out, shout out to one of our partners, Artie Kosaboom, like he's a millennial too. He wrote a book. He's really focused on contact center, which is what 5'9" does.
What's his name?
Artie Kosaboom.
How does he spell that?
I'll spell it for you.
All right. We'll put it in the chat. Shout out to Artie.
He wrote this a book called Enable Better Service. And I think that it's kind of in alignment with what your platform does, right? It's elevating those conversations that we're having. Oh, that's in a private chat. My bad. But I sent it to you. But it's enabling partners to have a better consultative conversation with their customers and not just go in just because they heard that I have this one project going on. It's like, no, invite them into the suite of technology and make sure that you're offering and solving for all of their needs, not just the one that might be paying you the most money.
That's what's up. So shout out to Artie. And let's make sure our platform is about the community. So we always want to shout out people that are doing great things, whether they're in the channel partner community or the extended business and Berber entrepreneur and sales community. I want to do a little technical check because, as you know, technology can fail at times. I want to make sure that our LinkedIn fam is able to see us. I know in our last broadcast, we had a couple of issues with that. One thing I want to let you guys know as far as with the Drinking Buddies platform and all the stuff that we're doing, make sure that you get on to businessandbourbon.live and you become a community member, because all of the content, all of our wonderful guests are all being loaded onto the platform. In fact, you can watch previous episodes of Drinking Buddies. You can watch the clips. We'll have the clips up there, I believe, next week. This one will be up there probably next week as well. So anyway, all right, you guys want to know what I'm drinking? Yep. I'm not as fancy as you, Kelli. But you look much more classier to me. Luckily, this, you know, so I'm going with some whiskey. Now, I want to shout out our friends at All Nations. I love this distillery. All Nations welcome except Kerry. You guys need to check these guys out. They're actually, I'll let you guys in on a little secret. They are sponsoring our national tour that we're about to announce. So really clap it out. Virtual clap. Woo! All Nations. Oh, Kelly, clap. All right. All Nations. Shout out to our friends, All Nations and Ray Franklin. All right.
That's exciting.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Boop.
Are we supposed to drink?
Yeah. Kelly, it's called drinking buddies. Yeah, you're supposed to drink.
We'll see how this ends. I mean, Chambord is not lightweight. You know, people think that it is.
See, that's the fun part of this. It's not about how we begin, it's how we end. These conversations get way more fun as we get to the end of our time together. All right. I've introduced you, but can you please first just kind of tell our audience what 5-9 does?
Yeah, so 5-9 is the intelligent contact center platform, and it really allows our customers to engage with their customers in whatever modes of communication they want. So whether it's social media or via telephone, which still is number one, a lot of people don't believe that, but it is. Whatever that platform is that our customers feel comfortable with, we're enabling their teams to interact that way with their customers to increase their experience, increase their sales and revenue, increase efficiencies. And then, you know, in the healthcare space, which happens to be one of our top verticals, it really increases the patient doctor or the patient nurse or this the patient facilitator relationships as well.
Okay. And if you could, for those, you know, there are folks that are watching that aren't familiar with indirect channel sales, which is really where your focus is. Could you tell them a little bit more about what it is that you do at 5-9?
Yeah, so thanks. You know, one of the things that I love mostly about indirect channel sales is that it empowers entrepreneurs like yourself to elevate the conversations with their customers. It allows me, they give me the privilege. I kind of always love teaching folks, but it allows me to help teach entrepreneurs how to sell this technology and that enables their customers to do great things and to grow their businesses, right? And so in that interim, for indirect sales, it's B2B. I'm technically selling to where you're my customer as an entrepreneur. As a reseller, there's some larger entrepreneurs and some smaller ones, right? But it allows us to be able to empower you with the education, the sales tools, and really the visibility into the technology so that when you're going to talk to your customers, you're having, like I said, a complete and consultative conversation, and you're able to bring in different technologies to solve for their needs and help them grow.
Nice. And I would agree with you, man. Just the opportunity for entrepreneurship and the indirect channel. And for those of you that are that's not a familiar term for you, it's basically when I explain it to people that aren't in telecom technology, software indirect channel sales, it's a little bit like insurance was more back in the day, right? Where your insurance agent might represent different lines of insurance, different companies, and you know they would sell you whatever insurance product, and then you know they would get a little piece of that bill that you pay every month. Very similar to that, except we're talking technology, telecom, software products, which are mostly B2B focused. Like your company's B2B focused, right?
Well, our company has a direct side as well. We are about 60% channels focused, though, this indirect channel that you speak of. Our partners really do help us get entrenched with their customers. And so what happens then is you're able to do kind of both sides of the house. So we do have a direct sales side, but we prefer to work with partners, too.
But all your customer, your product is focused on the B2B customer. Like you don't have consumer products, right?
No, we don't have really consumer products. Yeah, no, we're focused on, and like I said, enablement of the customer business of a business to talk to their end users and customers.
Okay, so my next question for those that are watching this, and you know, right now that you're checking out 5-9, you're going to the website, which is, it's just 5-9.com, right? Like
FIVE9.com.
Yeah, 5-9. Like they're checking out, and they're like, okay, well, I see what they do. Who or what type of company for you personally do you think is like an ideal type of partner? What does some of your successful partners look like in terms of the type of businesses that they're in?
Really, our successful partners come from every kind of background, right? We have a big LATAM group that in Latin America, all they do is go through businesses to be able to sell to their customers. Like they have a special segment there. For us, our customers here in North America, which, you know, I know that you're global, but we'll talk to them. You're our partners.
Worldwide, baby.
But our partners here, like I said, every background, because every customer could utilize contact center. I'll give the example again of, you know, healthcare. When you are in this space and COVID friendly, right? And you have a customer or you have a patient who can't come into the office, you know, you can have a video chat. We have an AC adapter, or we have an adapter into Zoom. So your patient can talk via Zoom. And then as that doctor or that nurse is, or practitioner is helping them, they can pull up all the information in the background about what the symptoms are, you know, what their past history is and whatnot. And so being able to link all that together, and I'm sorry about that noise. I'm trying to turn it off.
We're ignoring it. It's all good. You're doing business. You're a businesswoman. It's all good.
You hear all the emails. Apparently I'm a very busy businesswoman. I don't know. But yeah, so, you know, it really doesn't matter. We have top verticals, healthcare, retail business, services are kind of our top verticals, but I would say that, you know, bring us a customer who needs to increase their interactions with their customers, and we can help you solve that.
I want, you know, this is, we always want to keep these as interactive as possible. Thank you, Kelli. I appreciate your answer to that. The StreamYard platform, sometimes, you know, there's some delays in the comments, and I'm not getting comments shooting over right now, but I still want you guys commenting. I still want you guys collaborating, and make sure that we're keeping this communication going. I'm going to be checking all these comments too, because I'm going to be looking for some of the best ones to send some swag out, baby, because I am just full of swag over here. So I want to make sure you guys get some swag. And who knows, I might talk Kelli into sending some swag too, if you have a really cool comment or question. So if hopefully it all syncs up here soon. If it does not, that's cool. I want you asking your questions, because I will get them answered. You guys know how we roll. It's about the community. So if you're asking a question and we're unable to see it at this time, I'll follow up with you afterwards. We'll follow up with Kelli and make sure that we get those questions answered for you that you might have about what she does, about what her company does, and about some of this other stuff that we're about to dig into right now. But before we dig into it, Kelli, you better get a drink.
I have my drink.
I know, I haven't seen you drink it. This isn't called babysitting buddies. This is called drinking buddies.
I'm glad you're my last meeting of the day.
Why do you think I schedule it when I do? Listen,
That's fair. Thank you.
It's not about we're not tying one on like we're like we're at the bar or something. But we're gonna have a cocktail, have some real talk like we always do it on Business and Bourbon, and just talk about some topics that sometimes don't get a whole lot of attention. So. You are the founder of Xposure. Can you please tell our friends out there what Xposure is?
Yeah. Well, let me give a little bit of a backstory. Can I give a backstory first? So
it's your show.
Xposure was kind of this thought process and kind of brainchild of me falling into the channel, into this indirect services channel, which we had to explain to your listeners and everybody that's viewing, right? A lot of people don't know what that is. And I had no idea what it was 7 years ago when I came into this space. And so when I had the opportunity to come over to 5-9 from the organization I was working with before, I was like, man, it would be really cool if we were intentional about bringing people into this space and exposing them to other ways of getting into tech outside of, you know, today we only hear about coders and developers. We need those people. We need you, of course, right, to continue to elevate our tech. But we also need product managers. We need marketing. We need salespeople, right? We need those that can, you know, manage relationships. And so, you know, my thought was, how do we help people get into this space? And then how do we help people in the indirect sales channel space to find the right seat on the bus? Mm-hmm. And so Xposure is just that. It's the first agnostic diversity, equity, and inclusion, not a business resource group in the channel. And we seek to provide a collaborative space for those in technology to, you know, have access to career changing resources, education, mentorship, and even be able to do something with their time here. Not everybody has the time to go found an organization that is kind of pulling in the community, but you can come participate. Right. And so, you know, we're here to help to enable, you know, authentically enable each other to, you know, represent and bring in the channel and kind of create a succession planning for the technology channel too. So that's what we are. We have a lot that weighs on that though, since this time last year, a little bit before, you know, diversity, equity, and inclusion has been on the forefront of everybody's minds these days. And so, and rightfully so, you know, you kind of led with that when you talked about how businesses are leaning in to this space of creating an inclusive and a more culturally diverse organizations. Yeah. And so,
So they say.
There are some that are doing a great job and there are some that are still striving. I am worried about those that haven't done anything, right? Yeah. That's one, but you know.
So from your perspective, in your words, why? Like, why does this even matter? Like, you know, if I am whatever, Johnny Q, Jane Q, CEO, and I've got this, you know, this big company, why should I care about this? I'm doing great. Business is great. Why does this matter to me from a business perspective? That's one thing about altruism. Okay. That may be the right thing to do, but from a business perspective, why should I care?
You should care for a couple different reasons. One, your team spend more time together than they do with their own families, right? And so to have a more cohesive, productive, innovative team, you would likely need to create an environment where everybody felt welcome to show up as who they are, right? And that's the big piece about inclusive and being inclusive and creating an inclusive environment, right?
Yeah.
Because if I can't show up, you know, if I'm only showing up with maybe 25 or 30% of my story and who I am, then you're only going to get 25 to 30% of what I'm going to bring to the table. But if I can show up in my entirety, I can show up as Kelli McMillan, African-American woman who grew up in the city of Houston, who, you know, has this diverse background, I can safely bring all those experiences into my job. And, you know, then I'm helping not only my career grow and helping my family, but then I'm hopefully answering and solving for the company's, you know, goals and what we hope to do as an organization. So that's one. And that environment is so important. We all know, we all have worked in toxic environments and we don't work there anymore. You know, either we've started our own businesses like you have, or we move on to other organizations that have better environments. So it's really good for employee retention too. The other thing is we're so close to each other. And I think that it behooves us to take those experiences that we learn within this corporate environment from our communities and apply them in both directions, right? Because that's how we're able to amplify this message of just being a good human.
Yeah.
Being a good human doesn't have any prerequisites except that. Like you're a human, you're on this planet. We all know as we get to be older, we don't all have the same opportunities and advantages. So being a good human should happen inside and out of work, but you certainly want it at work.
Kelli, thank you so much for answering that and being so just eloquent in the way that you I gave you somewhat of a difficult question and a bit of a curveball. And guys, so you know, I didn't prep Kelli for that question. This is what she does. So she handled it with class and just like she looks. Like, would you expect anything otherwise? But the reason I asked that question is I think that sometimes when we're thinking about the right thing to do, you know, for it's really kind of this altruistic mindset, and we oftentimes try to make assumptions that companies and businesses want to do the right thing because, well, it's the right thing. Well, if that were the case, what you're doing with Xposure and what you guys have planned to do here in the future would not be necessary because that just would have happened forever ago, right? Mm-hmm. So that's why, you know, I like to change that conversation or evolve the conversation to, hey, look, what's the business impact? Because I know business language. I know corporate language. And companies need to know business impact. And if you've got something that can provide good business impact, and then, hey, it helps people. Oh, okay. They're in. And they'll actually really do more than just, you know, the superficial stuff, right? Like we had just like early on when I can't remember the question I asked you, but you made mention of companies doing more with diversity and inclusion. And I'm like, what, really? Are they? Because there is some superficial stuff out there. And I would submit that there's superficial stuff because there are companies that are doing things just because we're supposed to. And, you know, it's a publicity thing, right? But it's not really, they're not doing what they could be doing or doing more because they don't see the business impact. See, if we can articulate the business impact, a company, which isn't a person, the company's not a person, it's dollars and cents. If you can make that case, it helps to move whatever your cause is. And I would submit that in this economy, this global economy that we live in, where we're all connected now in ways that we never have been, your diversity is your strength, your ability to talk and communicate with as many different type of people and understand as many different type of people as possible and make people feel, as you so eloquently put it, make people feel comfortable in your in the work environment. And all this is so valuable to the bottom line. So it's not like just, hey, you should do this because it's the right thing to do. Yeah. No, it's the right thing to do, but this is good for your business. Would you agree?
I do agree. And you know, I often read different articles just to make sure I'm on par with what's going on right in the industry. And one of the things that I will say is recently Forbes launched an article that highlighted that organizations that are above average with their diversity, equity and inclusion, that means that their organizations are, you know, 40 to 50% more diverse, right? They have a 50% higher opportunity and attached to innovation that happens. Their company continues to grow versus organizations that don't, that their diversity, equity, and inclusion, their numbers are, you know, around 5%, you know, when it comes to those, the very different cultural backgrounds, they don't have the same rate of innovation and growth. And so to your point earlier, because you have people from various backgrounds, various education levels, various parts of the world, when you have that in an organization, then you get their viewpoints because they're sharing their experiences with you.
Yeah, I love that. And I love, you know, where you bring numbers and analytics to the table. That's direction that I would give anyone out there. Like, this is stuff that we talk about in sales. And sell, like, because a lot of times a lot of sellers are selling, they're selling to technical buyers and they're selling on emotion, you know, as opposed to being able to articulate business impact. You guys know I talk about emotion all the time in terms of motivation and everything. And every cell, there's an emotion in it. And you just have to understand what that emotion motivator is. But you have to be able to understand who you're dealing with in the sales process, just like we're talking about here, and be able to communicate with them in their language. So the point that I am making is that if you have a social movement, you have something that you're championing and whatever in your company, you have to understand how to articulate the business value, because a company has no emotion. They only have fake emotion.
Because they're trying to increase the
visuals have emotion, but the company. So like when you're talking about making big impact, like what you guys are doing in an industry that I quite frankly believe needs it. I've been in that industry for two decades, and it certainly needs more voices and more people at the table to continue to grow and be as strong as it's been. You mentioned something that I don't want to get lost on this as we're having this conversation, because I think especially here, because of in light of, you know, last year's events and continuing events, that when we talk diversity, inclusion, people think anything black people.
Yeah.
But as you put it earlier on, it's not just about black people. Can you elaborate on that a little bit?
Yeah, I can certainly elaborate a little bit. And you know, I'm glad that you're giving me the opportunity to, because a lot of times, even in the channel, I find that people think that I'm just referencing black people, and they're like, "Hell, I don't know if I can join." So I'm like, yes, first of all, we need allies, right? And so I want to talk about, you know, what allyship is versus, you know, what diversity, equity, and inclusion, how that plays together in a second. But to directly answer your question, diversity is the differences in racial and ethnic, socioeconomic, geographic, academic, professional backgrounds. It's people with different political, religious beliefs, sexual orientations, right? Disabilities, right? There's certain healthcare needs. There are all these different things that fall under the moniker of diversity. So when we're talking about diversity now, if you know, to be completely transparent, you're talking about a group of humans that have probably been more disproportionately hindered by the lack of opportunity or not having opportunities, then you do, you know, see more black and brown people falling into that bucket. But it doesn't matter. Sometimes, you know, and I don't want to say it doesn't matter, because for some of your viewers, they'll be like, what is she talking about? But it matters that we're being inclusive of everybody that's not getting their fair opportunity or fair share. Right. Yeah. And you know, when I talk to people about exposure, I'm literally saying, like, it doesn't matter what color you are, what age you are, what this looks like, right? If you're a business professional trying to, you know, seek to elevate your career, come talk to us. If you want to do some work championing, like, in your community around diversity, equity, and inclusion, and giving a voice to people who don't have one, come talk to us. Come spend some time and actually do some work.
I love it. I love it. I'd add to that. Going back to the business aspect of this, if you're someone in the indirect channel, and, you know, you're running a company or you're a leader in a company, and you care about the growth of your business, mm-hmm. you care about the growth of the industry, well, then you understand that we're not playing in a small playground anymore. We're playing in a global playground, right? And so to continue to grow, to continue to, and the indirect channel has experienced some tremendous growth over the last several years, and it's become pretty massive. But if you're going to maintain that sort of growth, if you're a forward-thinking business leader, you understand that you need more voices at the table. It's always, you know, there's always that old adage, Kelly, that, you know, if you're the smartest person in the room, you got a problem.
Yeah.
Right. It's the mm-hmm. same mentality. So if you're the smartest person in the room, you need to get in a different room. You need more smart people. So, you know, if everyone in the room, if you sit down at that table in your office, in your on your Zoom, wherever, and you look around and you do this, and everybody looks like you, or almost everybody looks like you, you got to do something. You got to do something, because not only we're all influenced differently now. So like, just because it's not just about skin color, for example, if I grow up in Midtown Atlanta, as opposed to, you know, Gainesville, Florida, my experience is different. My experience with people is different. But now the way that we're doing business now, the people in your offices, the people in your company, they're from all over, and they're influenced by all people, all different types of people and different types of cultures. And they may have a talent, they may have an ability that you're not really tapping into because of the inclusion thing. So they're walking a certain line feeling like, okay, I gotta be like Timmy because there's nine other Timmys at the table, as opposed to really embracing what makes them special and having the company endorse that and say, hey, look, you've got this unique thing about you. Let's embrace that. Don't be like Timmy. Let's be like you. And now let's use that to help us to elevate our business and to get into markets and communities that maybe we wouldn't be in otherwise.
You know, I gotta, you know, say something else about 5'9". So one of the reasons why I love our organization so much is that we leaned into employee resource groups before the rest of the world kind of made a big stand in the, you know, kind of line in the sand last year. And I'm grateful that other organizations did, but 5'9 did a really good job of leaning into that, you know, beginning of 2019. And so when we were having these conversations recently, there's been another organization within our ERG group that's focused completely on diversity, equity, and inclusion. So shout out to the Dialed In crew at 5'9". And one of the
shout
things,
out,
that, right, we just have a recent conversation that we were only kind of focused on North American kind of issue, or not really issues, but challenges with diversity, equity, inclusion, and highlighting those. And then somebody was like, wait, we are too a global organization. How come our Philippines office or our UK colleagues, or our colleagues in Russia, our colleagues in Australia, how can we represent for them as well? And so we just spent up an international group internally that's focused on diversity, equity, and inclusion as well, because their experience and their lenses are wildly different than ours. So, you know, I think, and then even on that, it's also good to see how the rest of the world views, you know, Americans. We want to know how the rest of the world looks at us too, right? So we're getting kind of different viewpoints of what we can do better. And it's only going to elevate everybody. So my other favorite quote is the rising tide lifts all boats, right? Mm-hmm. So you don't know what you don't know, but when you do, the responsibility is to do better.
Love it. Mm-hmm. Hey, shout out to you for acknowledging progress and action, right? In your company, 5'9". I think that's something that, you know, maybe doesn't get done quite as much because, and to be fair, when something hasn't been done for a long, 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 long time, and one thing gets done, it's like that salesperson that, you know, you got a $10,000 quota and you ain't hit it in 10 months and you just got a $1,000 sale. Yeah, we want to acknowledge it.
Yeah. Right?
Good job. Let's build on that. Good job. But we don't want to be like, yeah, yeah, we won. We're going to Sizzler.
That's about all you can afford on the $1,000 win. But yeah, to your point, but you have to acknowledge progress. Yes. Because one of the things that I would say is, although it's good for business and organizations are not taking a stand, a lot of times organizations don't know where to start. And they don't want to be offensive. That's what I've learned over the last few months. You know, we just launched membership with Xposure, but we've been doing this work since we launched in the channel in 2019. And so we have been having multiple conversations with big organizations in this space, and they'll get a cool badge here, you know, in the next couple of months or whatever. But they've taken their leadership through a consultative conversation around where to start. And it starts with, what is the end goal of your company culture, right? What's important to you? And so, and then them creating either an advisory board internally or kind of creating some metrics that are obviously in alignment with their growth, but also like it needs to be in alignment with what your employee, your current employees are telling you. Because to your point, you can't grow a business if you're not listening to what's going on internally already. Yeah. And so, and you can't expect to bring on new people to fix something if you don't fix it before you bring them on board, you know? So it's, you know, it's like trying to upgrade a house and you didn't fix the foundation. Well, you know, when you go to put those cabinets in, or, you know, something's gonna slide off the top because your foundation isn't fixed, right? So it's not solving the problem. So, you know, we've been helping organizations do that. And because at first I was like, why haven't you done anything, you know? And it's just literally because they don't know where to start, and good on them because they shouldn't offend, or they should get some direction on where to go with their, you know, content around diversity, equity, and inclusion.
So what's the end game, semi-end game for you? What is it that you ultimately hope to accomplish with your organization? Like, I understand that it's an ongoing thing, but what's that big goal that you're reaching for?
So there's two, right? One, I want to be able to create a sustainable, like our mentorship program, and eventually we'll be talking with partners about recruiting and even kind of putting up a space on our website for you to go and search jobs, right? So my goal is to make sure we don't lose this channel, because indirect technology channel, to your point, you know, it has really elevated and has changed a lot of people's lives, right? And it does allow entrepreneurs to have a play in technology, whereas they might not unless they go to work for some of the big tech companies. But in this way, you're still able to leverage that tech stack, but you can do it at your own, you know, pace, and really at what kind of focus that you want to have on it. So that's one thing. I want to create a succession plan for the channel. The other thing is, you know, I'd like to share as well, like, I don't want to recreate the wheel. There are some amazing organizations out here that are doing, you know, they're recruitment companies that focus on women or people of color. They're recruitment companies that focus on people with disabilities and helping them find jobs and different things. There's education platforms that talk about, you know, how to be a good salesperson, what you need to do to be a solid entrepreneur. We also want to give a voice for them, for these mm-hmm. small businesses, for people to leverage their resources. I like to say, like, you know, a lot of us grew up in the inner city where there was a church on every corner. I don't want to be a church. I don't want to be another just DE&I organization. I want to be the park where everybody comes to afterwards to collaborate and talk about what good things we were able to do, what took a little bit longer to, you know, be able to assess progress on, so that we can continue to elevate this conversation. I don't want it to get lost.
So say you want to get involved. Well, first of all, I understand that with those big goals, there are stages, right? There, yeah, in terms of what you're able to execute and what you want to execute. Like, what matters, not what matters most, right? But where are you most able to provide assistance right now in the channel, and to whom?
So today it's twofold. We're able to provide assistance to mid to small businesses, or mid to really actually any kind of business. We have some really big names that we're about to partner with for mentorship programs. So stay tuned for that. But some of our smaller partners too, who are from, you know, maybe more rural areas, or maybe all of them look alike in their company. And they're like, hey, Kel, how can we solicit more diverse candidates, right? And what do we need to pay attention to when these diverse candidates come on board? How can we create an environment where they can show up? So we've had multiple conversations on the business side. On the individual, whether you're an entrepreneur or, you know, a professional in this space, we're really focused on right now building out our regional touch points. So we have a central, east, and west coast lead chairs for the Central, East, and West. And so they are really spearheading different initiatives to get everybody together, come up with community events, things that are impactful in their community, and then also create a networking space where people can, again, it's agnostic, right? So we don't necessarily report into your business or another, but you're able to come together and have a conversation about how to find the right seat on the bus. It's, you know, learn more about technology from a local level and just from a one-on-one connection. So we're here about that too.
So how do people, how do they reach out? How do they get involved? How do they connect?
Yeah, I mean, you know, we have a LinkedIn space, Xposure IDC, or Xposure Inclusion and Diversity is on LinkedIn.
Just to clarify, can you spell that?
X-P-O-S-U-R-E. So Xposure.
There you go.
Yep. And so the website is, you know, Xposure, X-P-O-U. Did I spell that right? See, I'm moving fast.
I did. I told you it gets funner the more you drink. But
I know.
I'm on protein shakes now. That's pretty gross. I know, guys.
I'm like, how do you go from bourbon to protein shake?
You got
to
get the protein in however you get it in. You got to get it in. When it's time
you're just drinking it with your bourbon? Okay. All right.
I finished.
Okay. Yeah, I was like, that was a baby.
That doesn't mix well, though. That
later. But it's exposureidc.org. Or you can reach out to me directly, Kelli McMillan. You find me on LinkedIn, and we'll get you connected with a committee. So right now we have a few committees already spent up. We have an allyship committee. We actually just absorbed or kind of aligned with an allyship committee. And so I'm really excited about that. So our new kind of moniker is DE&I plus A. So diversity, equity, inclusion plus allyship, because there is a balance there, right? An ally is just that. You already have a seat at the table and you're bringing us in, or you're helping us break that table down so we can build a new one. So that's a whole nother conversation, probably for another day. But we have an allyship committee. We have a mentorship committee, a social engagement as well. And then you want to, you know, we have an education space too. We're creating a workshop right now that's a more formalized experience for some of our new partners and customers to come on and kind of learn what are the things that you need to focus on when you're building out your DE&I practice.
Love it. Kelli, thanks so much for sharing, but more importantly, thank you for your leadership. This is something that is long overdue, and I know that it may seem to some on the outside looking in that the need is maybe not what they think, but it is, because it's a massive industry, and there are people everywhere, right? But those people, and wherever they're at, they feel like they're kind of the only ones, but they are not. So those are voices that absolutely can help companies to grow, and those voices need to be elevated in order to really help sustain the industry and get it to where, keep it on the same trajectory that it's been on. So thank you for your leadership in that. I appreciate you, my friend. Again, guys, make sure you reach out, connect to Kelli, connect with her on LinkedIn, but more importantly, connect with her on businessandbourbon.live. Yeah. Join the community. So go to businessandbourbon.live, click the button, join, be a member. Kelly's there, I'm there, all the friends, all the cool kids are there. Like I'm telling you, the cool kids, they're there right now, chilling, hanging, having a great time. We need you guys there, because everyone that is watching this, you're a cool kid. We're all the cool kids, because we get that this is about community, it's about wisdom, it's about getting rid of that superficial BS that we see out there. That's what the Business and Bourbon platform is about. So please make sure you join. We have a lot of announcements coming very, very soon, as in starting next week. I want to tell you guys a little bit, but I cannot yet. I cannot. So I'm just going to tease it. Just make sure that you join and you'll be the first to know. There's going to be a lot of stuff going on, and we want you guys to be able to participate in it. We want your brands to be able to participate in it, because at the end of the day, what we want to help people do is better business. And whether it is through our media platforms, like Drinking Buddies, like the Business and Bourbon Podcast, top 200 ranked business podcasts, please. Come on, y'all know. Or our public events or private facing events. Everything is really focused on helping folks to do better business through building better relationships, deeper relationships, getting rid of that superficial stuff, really being focused on wisdom and education. That's how you, that's the long game. That's how you're successful, not just today. That's how you're successful many, many years from now, which is what I want you guys to be, just like Kelli.
Hey, and you know what? I have to say thank you because you, I mean, I remember you coming into the channel a couple years ago and I was like, who is this business and bourbon guy? You know, and it wasn't literally until recently in February, I was able to, you know, kind of bump into you at a partner event in person. Yeah. And, you know, we kind of start this friendship and I'm super excited for it. And I'm grateful for your platform because you're helping, you're a part of Xposure too, right? You're helping to expose the channel, the indirect sales channel to those who might not have ever heard about it. And really just great business. You're such a great business resource.
Thank you.
You know, your LinkedIn posts are always on time and on, like they're on focus with what we need to be doing to elevate our brands, elevate our sales pitches. And really while we're in this space is to grow our companies, right? Whether they're our own companies or a company that we're working for. So I'm super grateful for the platform.
Thank you so much, Kelli. I appreciate that. I really do. And with that said, man, again, it's been awesome. It's been fun. You shared some valuable information, guys. If you want to catch any of this on replay, go to businessandbourbon.live. This episode will be there. You can also, if you miss certain parts of it, there'll be some clips that are coming out here within the next couple of weeks. Just releasing some of this fire that Kelli dropped today. And if you can get involved, which you can, get involved, man. Get involved. If you're in the indirect channel, get involved. Not just because it's the right thing to do, which by the way, I'm cool with that. If you want to do just because it's the right thing to do, do it. But get involved because it's the right thing to do and it is smart business, guys. Mm-hmm. It is smart business to have diverse voice. So even if you may not have the opportunity to bring someone into your organization or whatever, having access to an organization like this where they can help give you some coaching and some mentorship to help you to up your game, this is going to matter with your with marketing, with sales, all this stuff. Because, you know, if you're ambitious out there, you want to be successful in this business or any business, man, you got to make sure that you up your communication game. All right. Bam, that was great. You're awesome. All you guys are out there awesome. And again, make sure you're connecting businessandbourbon.live. Connect with Kelli. And Kelli, I hope we got you started off with a good afternoon. But you better finish that drink.
Yeah. It's a good afternoon for sure. And I just one more thing. If I have to say anything, you know, our partner channel, you know, we talk about indirect sales channel. Five9 has a really strong platform to enable entrepreneurs to go out and grow their businesses. We have a partner portal coming. We have amazing, knowledgeable people that will handhold you through how to sell contact center to your customers. And so any customers out there, y'all want to talk to me, anybody that needs to be in alignment with somebody in their region, come talk to us because we're really about helping to empower you to increase your sales success.
And there it is. Thank you, my friend. Thanks, guys. Have a good rest of your night or evening or afternoon or morning, wherever the hell you are.
Bye.